Yeah, over to you.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm Mel Gould. I'm a school cycle officer. This is my second week of work, so I hope you'll forgive me if I've got some gaps in my knowledge. I work in a team with Anna Singleton and Jamie Dolling, who you might already know, among other people. So, yes, like many organisations, we've been thinking about what support we can offer in these slightly odd times. And as many of you will know, our purpose is to make it easier for people to walk and wheel, and there's so many benefits for people if they do that, and also for the planet. So we are traditionally, we think about cycling, but there's all sorts of different ways that people might walk and wheel, and we want to support all of those. So our goals really at this time are to increase active travel to school. We also want to increase awareness on the benefits of active travel, and particularly around the current urgency around active travel, both from a public health perspective and an environmental perspective. And there's the usual public health perspective, plus there are benefits with regards to COVID as well. And we also want to help to increase understanding of changes to neighbourhoods. So for example, some of you may or may not be aware of something called school streets, which I'll talk about in a little bit. So really where schools and the council and SusTrans are putting in sort of changes to streets around schools, it's helping everybody to understand those changes, what they're there for, and to really make them as effective as possible and as safe as possible for everybody. And we also want to really try and communicate really widely about what we're doing, and make sure that we're including everybody. So if you ever see that we're not doing that, I would definitely encourage you to give us some ideas of how we could do that better. So I mentioned school streets, and I think Danny also mentioned school streets. So this is really about having safer, spacious school drop-offs areas. And as you can see from the photo, it means that people feel safer to walk and cycle, and that there's enough space, particularly with regards to keeping COVID safe, for people to do that. So I might have got the numbers slightly wrong, because I noticed that Danny gave some different numbers, but from what I know, there's been at least 24 school street interventions, which can be anything from putting in some cones to kind of stop parking on curbs and things like that. There's various different interventions that help to calm the sort of street immediately around schools. There's been 3 school street closures, which means that just immediately outside of the school, during drop-off and pick-up times, the school is the street is closed to motorised traffic. And there's going to be 2 more of those after half term in Leicester. And the way that generally works is that's supported for 2 weeks by SusTrans and the council, and then it's handed over to the school to supervise and monitor. And it's usually very simple, involves putting out some cones and a sign, wearing a high-vis jacket, and just, you know, keeping that boundary so that motorised vehicles don't come in. And then the benefits, reduced air pollution, safer drop-offs and pick-ups, and increase in active travel and better health outcomes. So in terms of our active travel support offer, apart from that, we have had to move some things virtually that we would normally do in person. So we can absolutely meet with school active travel champions, whether they're staff or if you've got student groups, we can set up meetings like with eco crews and things like that as well. And we can deliver lessons, assemblies. We're planning to have an e-newsletter, a monthly one. And also we can support with personalised travel plans, and that can be for staff and for children and families. So really, people who are looking to move towards a more active form of travel, helping them to travel to plan safe journeys that they'll feel confident with. And they have, we've actually also done some led rides with people who are then testing those out. So all that's on offer. Currently, we're not offering in-class stuff, but I know that Sustrans is trialling some COVID secure in-class delivery, and we've been asked to let them know if we're getting any requests from schools for that. So if you do want that, please do let us know. It wouldn't be immediate, but we are in the process at Sustrans of looking at how that might look. And we can also offer materials and support for a bike to school week. So normally bike to school week happens all at one time, and that time has gone. But what we're suggesting to schools is you can choose your week and we will support you with the activities for that week. And that would be something that could happen. There's actually, it doesn't all have to happen at the same time. And particularly at this time, it's just more helpful, we think, for schools to be able to pick their week. There's the Big Street Survey. This is a great series of activities and lessons. It's like a big geography project, really, but with lots of different other curriculum, cross-curricular aspects. And this can really easily be done in a COVID-secure way. And we can provide all that you need for that and help you deliver it. There's a resource pack for active travel lessons with curriculum links, which we provide. We can support with bike counts, wheelie walkie Wednesdays, some schools do, or if you don't want it to be a Wednesday, we are able to provide alliterative titles for pretty much any day of the week that you like. And maybe if you would like to trial something in your school, like an active travel champ award on a monthly basis, perhaps one per year group or per key stage, perhaps one for staff as well, where there's a chance for people to show how they've changed their travel or what they're doing to travel in an active way, and really celebrate that. In person, we can come and offer outdoor sessions. We can come and do Dr. Bike information stands, street assessments, which are part of the Big Street Surveys. We can support with cycle maintenance, learn to ride and balance bikes. And we've all obviously got a risk assessment process in place to manage that in a COVID secure way. And just finally, just to say, this is a really interesting time for schools to promote active travel. This article just talks about how more people are exploring active travel options during COVID. And also there's been a survey in Leicester which shows that a very large proportion of parents really want their children to cycle or walk to school and want to support them with that. But they also are very concerned about safety and traffic and things like that. It's a really great time to encourage it and to offer ways of doing those things in a safer way, to do those kind of school street interventions and just to sort of promote the benefits to everybody, really. So get in touch if you like any help with that. There's my contact details.
Brilliant. Thanks, Mel. And you've got 20 seconds left, so it's almost timed perfectly. So that's brilliant. Thank you very much. I'll just stop that recording.